What's up YouTube, welcome back to another JF production studio video. So in this video I'm actually going to be showing you guys how to unbox and open up your very own figpin. I'm just going to be taking you guys through just some of the steps I learned on how I open up my pins, just more so that you don't damage your pin if you're trying to collect these things. And I'm also at the very end going to be showing you how to put this pin into the app to unlock it for your own personal online collection. So stay tuned and I hope you guys enjoy the show. All right, so here we go. We'll get right into unboxing this pin. It was an exclusive from a Big Bad Toy Store, it's an online company. There you go, the Big Bad Toy Store partner exclusive 2020. Let's get into the process of actually opening this thing. Most of them come with this little plastic cover on the top. They'll have a thing like this. You just take that, pull down on it. Real simple. And I always like to use what I call the slide technique. And so what it is like that. You just let the pin slide right on out. It's less work. So you also need to be aware of some of these pins are very valuable and have their own collectible value, just like anything. You do want to keep that in mind that, you know, some of these pins could be worth a lot of money one day. You want to do what you can to keep it in the best condition. So the first step is popping up this top part. What I like to do, you just put a finger right here, just pull up on it, real easy. And then the other side will come out just like that. And the next step that I like to do is bend these folds right here. Bend them, you bend that down and bend this down. So every fold you bend. So it's just gonna make it that much easier. So if you see it just like that, then what you're gonna want to do is slide technique. Once again, hit it with that slide technique. And you just take your pin, tip it upside down, and just let it slide. Super easy. Boom. Just a tip. A lot of collectors will actually, they'll care a lot about this plastic container. To some people, it's just a plastic case, whatever. They'll take it, they'll throw it away. A lot of collectors will look for this actual container that goes around the actual fig pin. You're gonna wanna keep on, hang on to this, at least if you're looking to invest in some of these pins or to collect it and keep it in pristine shape. If you don't have the box, it's gonna significantly reduce the price of your overall pin. You hang on to this black part at the bottom, make sure that's down. So what you're gonna wanna do is very gently apply some pressure and do a little wiggle. Make sure you don't bend the corners. So yep, as soon as you feel it loose, you want to be very carefully, just pull up on it. Your next step, you're going to want to take out the slider card. Same thing with this, you just want to slide it right out. I like to hold it from the sides and just kind of treat it like a trading card. Removing the pin completely from everything. You're going to want to grab the pin here, grab it from the sides like this. Grab this plastic cover, plastic rubber stopper from the back. Put your finger down here and just kind of pull up on it like that and just pop it right out. So here, the final step is putting this back on here. You can see here, it has three holes. You're gonna wanna line up the three holes so that, you know, it's pretty close to the actual pin. There you go. So there you have it. That's my process on how, I take these pins out of the box without damaging them. These can end up turning into a very collectible thing. They're starting to, you never know. They're super cool, so they definitely have that appeal to collectors already. So I mostly like to keep them in the box. I don't take them out that often unless I'm checking the scores, which I'm about to show you right now how to check that score. So next thing you're gonna wanna do is put your figpin and unlock it under the app. Open the app, click on this unlock.
is take the back code of the pin. Every pin has a code on the back, and type it into that unlock section. Let the computer do its thing, calculating your score, and there you go. Wa-bam. So all his stats will come up with a little picture. You can check the score of a pin without actually adding it to your collection. Yeah, so that's a little breakdown of the actual app. Mainly the main things I look at is the addition of the pin, obviously the volume too. I don't want a pin that has 20,000 prints of it and everyone has. So you don't even need to be logged in to check the actual score of your pin. But yeah, I think it'd be cool if they designed something where you can battle other people and do some kind of gameplay with the pins, and yeah, that'd be super sick. I don't know, you guys tell me what you think.